every single thing that you've gone through equips you to be able to do what you were born to do.
Welcome back to the Find Your Purpose Now podcast. I'm Rhonda Sciortino, and I want to talk to you about trying something new in the new year. You know, a lot of people talk about New Year's resolutions, and let's just be honest and say they don't usually last. They don't usually work. It's because it's not a lifestyle change. It's not a life change. And so I want to encourage you to just think differently. Think about what you want to do differently in the coming year. What do you want to do differently within 24 hours? I hope that it has to do with finding and living your purpose. And so many people, I think, just don't do it because they think, well, I don't know how to do it. Okay. Think about the first job that you ever got hired for. You didn't know how to do it. You might have had a degree in it, and you go to get that job and you don't really know how they want you to do that job, what they expect of you, how is it going to be on a daily basis? Nobody does. I mean, unless your parents were entrepreneurs and you grew up in the business, I mean, maybe you would. But for most of us, we really don't know. And so what happens? You show up on the first day. You start to learn your way around. You learn the ropes. Hopefully somebody takes you under their wing and teaches you something. You didn't know about school when you went to school, kindergarten for the first day. What about when you started middle school on the first day? Everybody's nervous. First day of high school, first day of everything that you've ever done, every place that you've ever gone, you didn't know how to do it until you started to do it. So think about your purpose this way and the opportunities that are presented in a new year. I hope that you'll say yes to more things in this new year. You might find that something that you agree to do is life-changing. Maybe it leads to a whole new career. Maybe it leads to you finding something that you're really passionate about. Maybe it leads to you meeting your best friend. We're meeting somebody that you want to spend the rest of your life with. Let's decide that we're not going to be fearful in the future. That we're going to run into this next year with reckless abandon toward our purpose. Say yes to anything that sounds like it might move you towards your purpose. The way you'll know is that you'll be using skills, talents, abilities, intelligences, your personality, your character traits. You'll be using these things that define who you are. And all of that helps other people. Maybe the key is saying yes to any opportunity to help someone else, because you just never know where that's going to lead. And it's exciting to think about this being the year that you say yes to going into business with somebody, that you say yes to inventing a product that you've always known would be helpful to other people, and you just haven't had the courage, maybe, or had the time. to figure it out, do that. Maybe this is the year that you quit the job that you hate and move into something that you love doing. Quit worrying about who's going to think what and do what you really want to do. I'll tell you, I knew somebody who was a lawyer and absolutely hated it. And when I met her, she was a waitress in a little coffee shop in, kind of out in the boondocks. And she had been a big city person and kind of a big deal in the law firm where she was. And she left it all. And here she was, pouring my coffee and refilling my water and, you know, bringing my meal. And I had the opportunity to talk to her. And she talked about how she was happier than she had ever been. Imagine. There will be people who will say, you're crazy. Don't do that. Or, you're going to give up that job and that paycheck. Well, you know what? Do have a plan. If you're going to go to another job, have that other job before you quit the first job. I mean, be responsible about it. But stop holding yourself back. Take a risk. It's a new year and it's a new opportunity for you to find the purpose for which you were made. In the Bible, in Ephesians 2:10, it says that you are God's masterpiece. I believe it. I just choose to believe it. I think that you are amazing. You're a unique combination of DNA, of character, personality, intelligence, skills and talents, abilities, strengths, all the things that make up who you are. You're unique in all the world for all time. Think about that. There's never been another person in all of human history who has the exact same fingerprint that you have. The same is true for the combination of things that make you who you are. There's a reason for your life. In fact, the rest of that verse says you're God's masterpiece created by Him to do a specific work, a specific thing. And you could do it to some extent without any faith. You can use your talents and not ever plug in to faith. But I say plug in specifically because when you plug in to faith in God through Jesus, don't roll your eyes. Don't turn it off. I'm telling you, I was raised by atheists. I know what that is. There's no hope in that. There's no joy in that. There's no peace in that. But if you will suspend your doubt and just choose to believe that you are an intentional, not an accident, that you were intentionally created by a creator who's much bigger than you, quit trying to, you know, pull him down and fit him in a box and figure them out. It's okay to not figure everything out and to just choose to believe. And when you do, amazing things can happen. You're no longer alone. You're not alone in your journey. When you ask God, okay, I'm going to just choose to believe what feels like a fairy tale. I mean, be honest, he already knows. So say what you think and say what you feel. And you can also say, help me in my unbelief. Help me to suspend my doubt. Help me to choose to believe. And then point me toward my purpose, the purpose for which I was born, the purpose for which I was created. Because when you do that and you begin to go in that direction, it's amazing what will happen, truly. I mean, I went from the 8 to 5 job, which really was more like 6:30 in the morning till 6:30 or 7 o'clock at night. Unappreciated, not well paid, feeling like there was just no meaning to it at all, no value to it at all, kind of drudgery. And I was diagnosed with cancer. And I had surgery, and while I was laying there trying to recover from the surgery, I just started praying. And I thought, okay, I mean, I was 27 years old. And I said, okay, God, what do you have for me? I mean, am I going to live another year? Am I going to live another 60 years? Whatever the time left in my life, help me to do something good with it. And while I was recovering, I had a strong urge to open up my own business. I was I worked in an insurance agency. I started working in insurance when I was 15. But I didn't know anything about running an agency, finding the insurance companies. I didn't know anything about the accounting. There were so many things I didn't know. And I think if I hadn't been partnering with God, if I hadn't said to God, okay, take my life and do something good with me, good with my life, I think I would have talked myself out of going into business because I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't have any money. I didn't have any family. I didn't have any safety net whatsoever. But in that conversation with God, while I was laying there trying to recover from surgery and wondering how much life I would have left, I had this overwhelming feeling to just start my own insurance agency, to specialize in protecting the good people and organizations that take care of abused children, because I had been in the child welfare system. And I didn't even know where to start. But I said yes to God. And I'm so glad that I did, because I spent decades negotiating insurance programs for amazing people and organizations that do really good things in the world. And I'm so glad I did it. We saved, oh gosh, I actually quit counting. It was tens of millions of dollars in insurance premiums for private nonprofit child welfare organizations. That was money that they were able to spend on children instead of insurance premiums. So no, I wasn't a foster parent. I wasn't a social worker. I wasn't a mental health professional. I put money back into the budgets of the child welfare organizations that I served. And that was a good thing. I was indirectly able to help children whom will never know my name, who will never even know what I did. And I say that to say, when you say yes to God and you just run with reckless abandon into God's plan for your life, just say yes and be willing to talk to the people that he directs you to, be teachable, listen carefully to the advice that people give you, especially older people who have been there and done that. You just don't know the good that you'll be able to do. And the good things that'll come to you. The relationships that I made in those years are priceless, priceless to me. Some of my friends I've had for, gosh, almost 40 years now. I wouldn't trade that for anything. It's all part of God's purpose, and he has a purpose for you too. And it may not look anything like mine. If you decide to say yes and you take a leap in this new year, I hope that you'll contact me. Go to my website, Rhonda, R-H-O-N-D-A.org, and let me know. I want to hear your story. I'd love for you to come and join me in this, let me point the other way, this fake chair that's right here next to me, and share your story of taking the leap and where that leads you. It is a wild ride. I will tell you, if you do this, if you say yes to God, buckle up, buttercup, because it can be a wild ride. This has taken me places that I never thought I would go. I've been to the Vatican at sunrise. I've been in the tunnels of the Capitol. I've been on the Today Show and in lots of different TV shows. And I'll tell you, I'm an off-the-chart introvert. If somebody would have told me that I was going to go all these places and be interviewed by all these different places, oh my goodness, EWTN, Focus on the Family, ABC, NBC, Fox, you know, all these different places, I would have said, put down the crack pipe and step back. There's no possible way. This is crazy. You're crazy. But it happened. It happened. And nothing is impossible for God. When we say yes, you open up doors that actually you could never open up. God opens up the doors. And he'll see you through every step of the way. I didn't say it was going to be all, rainbows and unicorns and glitter. There are some hard times. There are some really hard times. An insurance company that I was a part of was located in World Trade 2 on the day of the attacks. I did business early on with an insurance company that had started in the 1700s. It was an A-rated carrier when they filed bankruptcy. What a disaster. There were so many different things that happened to me. An employee stole my American Express card out of my wallet and charged up furnishings for an office and her whole wardrobe for herself. And stuff happens. It's not all smooth sailing. But when you say yes to God, He will see you through it all. You just have to keep saying yes and keep holding on and keep having faith and keep having hope and keep saying yes. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope that you'll come back and join me on this journey of finding and living your purpose, the purpose for which you were born, and you were perfectly matched. All right. Happy New Year.
The things that you've been through have changed the way you see the world. They've qualified you to do what you were born to do and perfectly matched to do. Is there anything more important than finding and living the purpose for which you were born? I don't think so. I think that's the point.